Entering the month of Elul, the month of repentance, preparing for the day so far, Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, we advise very much to get my book, Repentance in Words and Letters, and it is in my site, gladysonbooks.com. Now, about this book is the following. This is a book which provides deep insight into the meaning of sin and punishment, commandments and reward. The significance of repentance emerges beautifully from the letters and words connected with the word of repentance. So like all my books, but also fine others, all deal with the Hebrew letters, because those are the letters with which the world was created, and this is a letters with which man was created. In fact, it is interesting to point out, according to Kabbalah, and books which are to the mysticism, clearly say that the reason that our confession on Rosh Hashanah, you know, is built on the Aleph Bet, like Ashamnu, Bagadnu, Gazalnu, Min Aleph Bet, Gimel Daled, also Al Chet Shechatanu, because of the sin that we sin. And the reason is because our being is based on letters, and doing a sin which had a great effect on the soul, the spirit, and this causes this connection, or as we say, twisting the letters, yeah, letters which represent positive, by sinning, we affect the build-up of words and letters, which is the build-up of the soul, the spirit, and therefore troubles comes. Lucky, perhaps I give you an interesting example with the book of Formation, which is related to Abraham, says that the greatest and the highest level in man's life is Oneg, Ayin Nun Gimel. Oneg is enjoy. Yeah, enjoy Oneg, Oneg Shabbat, yeah. And the worst situation is Nega. Nega is sicknesses, diseases, and troubles, and all kinds of plagues, whatever it is. Basically the same letter. Only in Oneg you have Ayin Nun Gimel, the letter Ayin, which represents understanding also, Yun, thinking. This letter is in Oneg in the beginning, in the Nega in the end. And the idea is that if a man lives.
Shalom, my name is Or, which is the Hebrew word for light. If you already knew this, you must have a special interest in the Hebrew Bible.
According to a proper understanding, really understanding which comes from the mind, your mind, not from emotions, feelings, on, then really enjoy life, interesting. But when it lets the mind thinking to be under emotion, which is putting it in the end, is a tensions and all these depressions, all this is a source of sicknesses. So amazing, the idea of confession according to the alphabetic order is based on this, as the Kabbalistic commentator said. So the alphabet are the most important things. Now, let us really tell you some of the chapter book, which contains few chapters, and it has about 100, more, let's see, almost 180 pages, and all of them deal about this idea of repentance, what is a sin, what is a punishment. So it is interesting to point out, really, this is what I brought here, which says that in a negative influence on the godly soul, of a person surrounding the soul with a coarse materialistic covering that impels its spiritual powers. It means that by doing sins, a man builds up and covers his heart with covering shells, which we call mystical way, which affect the emotions, the feelings, Now, it is so interesting to point out is how can see, how one can see this through the meaning of the word sin. So this idea can be seen by the structure of the word for sin. It's a chet. So chet is the letter chet, tet, aleph. Chet, tet, aleph. And this is really already in these letters, you can see the idea. Why? Because these three letters, chet, are composed of the letter tet, chet, and aleph, which is in Hebrew, tach, is to plaster. Yeah, you are plastering, you are covering, tiach, you know, when you are making, you know, our house nice and so on, so we put tiach, tit, around this, with mortar. And in fact, by sinning, you are plastering, covering, what you are chet, the letter aleph. What is aleph? Aluf, of the verb. This is the source of our soul, which is part of God. Aluf, of the verb. In the Bible, aluf is God. In English, aluf is a lofty man, taken from Hebrew, very likely. Because the meaning of aluf is aleph, lamed, pe. Once we discuss a lot about this, 111. Beginning, source of creation, God. So, when you are sinning,
there is a huge fundraising deadline coming up for Senate Democrats, and they need your help right now if they're going to meet it.
Every dollar you give.
Build up of chetet and aleph, there is aleph in the end, then you are plastering, you are covering this godly part in you. And then, you know, they're not so good, and all your behavior is not the right way of behaving. So, this is really what a sin does to you. So, how you break it? How you break it? How you break this really chet, the main letter which represents really the mortar, the material, is the letter tet in it. Chet is a sin, represents the situation of sinning which brings you down, you know, it means it's the letter chet, is the opening down to physical. But tet, the letter tet, is really representing the mortar, the physical. Because in Hebrew, this, there is a book which is called Otiyot of Rabbi Akiva, the letter of Rabbi Akiva. And there, he brings the letter tit close to the Hebrew word tit. Tit is mortar, material. And he says that really, this comes out definitely from this. So when a man is doing a sin, he builds up this mortal, this physical, materialistic part in him. And also amazing is the word tuma. What is tuma? Not yuma, but tame, yeah? Impurity. Now here all you have the letter tet in the beginning, in chet, you have the chet in the beginning, then the tet. But in impurity, tuma, tameh, you have the tet in the beginning, in the, and also you have the aleph. Yeah. Also the letter aleph, aluf, represent Adam. The letter aleph in Adam is a spiritual. So what it shows? It shows tameh, that you are metamtem, you know, tam is like to block. Really spiritual blockage, yeah? Sometimes a man who does not really, does not mind, his mind does not function properly, at tam. So tam is really is also blocking, yeah? Not me, tamot. So if one becomes impure by unfortunate drugs, I'm addressing the Torah, many sexual matters, yeah? Right? This tam, this like blocked, look, the Aleph, Aluf, part of man. Aleph is the Neshama, which is part of God, as we said, Aluf of the world. So interesting that Tameh and Chet both have the letter Aleph, spiritual, Neshama, the spirit of man, the soul, which is controlled by letters Tet or Chet, Tet. So how you are rectifying see, now you are doing tshuva. What are you supposed to do? So we know there are three important stages.
My daughter's name is Melanie. She has a godlike spirit in her. She's beautiful.
In tshuva, to do proper repentance. The first one is leitcharet, charata, regret. Second one is we do it. Confession. You have to confess. What you did is confession, as we said, it comes to alphabet. And then what you have to do is definitely to change all your deeds, to behave differently, in accordance with the Torah. Shinui ma'aseh. So charata is regret. But it is very interesting that charata in Hebrew is also lachot, to engrave. In the material, you are engraving. Charot, charata. So regret and charot, engraving, goes together, right? Because if you really regret properly, then you charot, you engrave on this plaster that you build around your heart. In a deeper way, it is interesting that the letters chet reish of charot, your chet reish, are letter of really, in Hebrew choris, to make a hole. Charov, it means, if you have many words, this is really also interesting principle in Hebrew language, the first two letters are the most important, and the third one is like description, or something which adds to the main part. So charot is like making hole or engraving on the material. So charov, we destroy also chetresh in the beginning. Charosh, plowing, also chetresh, because you are doing like a hole, you are breaking something. And this is exactly what one gets by doing proper regret. When he regrets really deeply from his heart, so he's meaning to break this teeth, this mortar from his heart. Yeah, the shells, the clipot. Very interesting. I saw in a book called Shem Yishmol, but he brings it in the old days, they used to put the forehead of dead people, the letter Tet. Interesting, Tet. For the letter Tet in a negative way represent really death, because this is material, you know. This is what meant to die. If Adam would not sin, he will live forever, because he sinned, he did not live forever. Death came to the world. So some really say the English word dead. Better to say in other languages, like Afrikaans, Dutch, is tet, tot, in German, amazing, tet, exactly the expert. This is a pronunciation of the letter tet. Death, yeah, amazing. This material goes, materialism goes together, amazing. So when you regret charata properly, really you regret what you did wrong, you realize what you did wrong. And fully, really, fully feeling it, you are breaking the shells, the covers, the plaster on your head. Yeah. Interesting, amazing to see. Hebrew verse show it. And the same combination is in Hebrew, you know, you have taruach, yeah? Which is really, as you say, to bother, to work hard, you know? The same thing, the regrets should be out of tircha for really working hard, yeah? So, as we said, amazingly seeing in the first stage of repentance, breaking this tet. This material was built because of the chet and because of the tameh, both of the tet in them. And, as you saw in this word, chet and tameh, the letter aleph in the end, because this exactly shows that this forces of evil. Yeah, which also evil, maybe in English you can say the same as the evil build up veil around your heart. It's also good. Arival was, we read about the mountain of Eval just last Shabbos. Maybe also this Eval, if you will pronounce evil like with the letters Eval, yeah. This was the R, the curses came on. Fasting also might be a connection. In fact, I wrote a book about this connection between English and Hebrew. Hebrew source of languages, which was recognized by some universities in the state. One can see it in the books of Dr. Isaac Mosesson. Abraham Mosesson wrote wonderful books about it. The Hebrew language, the word, and many others, which really he brought this connection to Hebrew in a very academic way, and it was recognized as great linguists in the state, and some of them really changed. They said, you have to revise what we taught. It's a fact, but that is a known fact. So, tracing many examples like this, but one of them, a few of them really. So, now we understand why the letter Tet in Tameh, Charot, Chet Tet in Echet, but why? The letter Aleph we said.
Hey, if you have more than $30,000 in the bank and you have not heard about Amazon automation, I guarantee you, you are losing.
Because these are really forces which affect the Aleph, for part of God in man. But what is interesting that you have very interesting phenomena in the word Chet Sin. And what you have in it, you have the letter Aleph, and you don't pronounce it. You have the Chet, even the Aleph. You see, in Hebrew you don't have such phenomena. I mean, you write in 10 letters and you say in 2. Like in French, you can see it very often. You say I, and you write it many. In Hebrew, not such a thing. Every letter and its place. There are only few chet or shav which have the aleph not pronounced, but is there. So it is an interesting explanation. And also, not coincidence, it shows you that by sinning, you are paralyzing yourself to your aleph. It means the aleph, the neshama, part of God in man, does not function. Is there. Yeah? So what we are doing, so sin, as we said, chet, is really unintentionally, not so severe. So you are doing tshuva, repenting properly, and then you revive this aleph to function. But it's an amazing phenomenon that you have a letter which is not pronounced. And the teaching is, again, that by sinning. And so it is with other Hebrew words connecting with sinning or blaming or doing something wrong. Like the Nachmanides says something interesting. He says that the word Hashem in Hebrew, Hashem is guilty, or Hashma is guilt, blaming. He said this is a word which pronouncing it is Hashem, 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 Hashem. Now the word Sham in Hebrew is to do with Shmama, Shomem. Sham, Shama, Shama is a desert of desolation. So he says something amazing. He says that really by sinning, you cause your Aleph to be deserted, like to be isolated, not to function properly. Amazing. This is Ramban Zen. The word Ashma, Sham, yeah, Aleph, Sham, Sham. The Aleph, the look is Sham. If you take the Hebrew word for Isur, prohibition, the root is Asur, Aleph Sar. The Aleph Sar, in Hebrew Sar is removed. Yeah? The Aleph is removed from you. Then you become like a behema, like an enemy, you know, and you are controlled under animalistic forces. Isur, Ashma, amazing. All these things, Tameh, Tumah, you see how all these verses in Hebrew shows you.
Shalom, friend. My name is Dr. Eli Lizorkin Eisenberg, and today I'd like to tell you about my...
What is happening to your neshama, by sinning? Sinning is something which really causes damage to the soul of man, right? To the spiritual being. So this is why sins are so severe in Judaism, yeah? For that very look like really doing not so, you're doing very tiny sin on Shabbat and so on. And in time that you have the Beit Din and the witnesses and all the condition, a man should be stoned and frightening, yeah? Why? Because he did that. Because you don't know what he caused to himself, and he needed a very severe operation. So by in Judaism, punishments is the operation, you know. If you want to live spiritual life, if you want that the soul will carry on, then you need, when you have spiritual cancer, so you need operations, and the operation, unfortunately, is not so convenient. All across all these things is a result of this. Because also besides the idea, as we said, causing damage to your soul, to the Aleph, yes, there are evil forces, you know, there are evil forces of the Satan. And those evil forces, they get a lot of energy when somebody is doing a sin, yeah? And those evil forces, you know, the Satan comes out, you know, Hitler, Marshman, all the other, and you see what they are doing. But it's the power of the setting, clear. Proofs, it's abroad, and it's written there. Hitler was really working with the Satan. And the Satan becomes strong because of the very severe sins at that time, you know, in Germany, assimilation, leaving the Torah, the race of the Torah. And the result was a very severe operation, and this operation really gave and brought the existence to Israel to carry on. Who knows? If this assimilation would carry on, who knows what would be with Jews? They say that now we lost Jews, and Jewish people which really we have the concept of tradition before their parents, grandparents, really were keeping Torah and everything within the Jewish community. So now we lost more than 6 million were assimilated, and already their children and grandchildren out of Judaism. So there is also spiritual, unfortunately, Holocaust.
What's this? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance so you only pay for what you need?
Distance shouldn't stop the office party. Move it online with Miro, where remote teams connect.
In Israel also, we start with this now, being Arabs and so on. So no doubt that this is really what is caused by sin, by impurity. So Teshuva, repenting, keeping the Torah, rectifying this situation, yeah, rectifying this situation of the damage done to your soul. This is so important to regret, to confess, like confess, because in confession one really verbally says the verse, but he did wrong, and this itself definitely very much helps to rectify the neshama, the soul. So as I said, what I told you just now is a little bit of my book, Repent, Words and Letters. And as I said, this is unfortunate. People don't realize, don't know, and don't really understand what sins, iniquities are doing to the man and to the world. So this is what I found so important to really show how so many important principles, foundations of repentance is within the letters. So I recommend really to get this book. It's already another edition, I think the third edition, but important one. And that's a subject really, it will open your mind, which is important really, as I know that unfortunately when I speak with people, they don't understand what is a sin, what is a punishment, what it does, what causes, but definitely, for this one I have to learn. And the month of Elul, as we spoke a lot about this month, about the letter Elul, all of those letters, as you saw my lecture about Elul, the secret of Elul, shows that the letter Elul, letters Elul, Aleph is Ulpan, learning, Lamed is learning, and Aleph again learning, Lamed again. And proper learning should be with the Lamed, with the heart. Lamed, as we said, is the shape of the chamber of the heart, and two Lamedim is a full heart. So, learning is the most important, because without learning, as I see really people response to my YouTube and so on, I can see, unfortunately, very narrow-mindedness, not really understanding. Okay, don't have to blame them, because don't have to learn, they're busy. Their life, professions, and that. But learning, also start with Lamed, you know, learning.
And you can customize and save with Liberty Mutual. Shocking, right?
Introducing the Mobile Skimmer. So we've partnered with, as well as built out a team of engineers to custom manufacture this
The Lamed L is a letter of learning, Lamed. So in English also, learning starts with L, learning, no? You have to learn, no doubt. So, let us finish here, and we hope in Yer Sashem to give more lectures on this idea about the Hebrew letters. As I said, my first book, Letters so far, goes into the letters generally, but in this book, Repentance, in words and letters, I concentrate on the letters and the deep idea behind the names of iniquity. Also, I didn't speak about iniquity, which is the Avon. Avon is Avon Nun. Nun is a 58, also represents the soul from another point of view, and when it's avon means to twist, distort. Exactly the same idea, avon nun. You're distorting the nun, the light of your neshama, you distort, you cover. This is avon. So it means beautifully to see how much is behind every letter in the Hebrew language, the letter with which God created the world. Bereshit bara Elokim et. In the beginning, God created from Aleph, fell to the top. Yeah? And this is in the verse, because it should be written in the beginning, Bereshit bara Elokim shamayim va'aretz. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. By the word et, Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim. No. You know, God was very particular on each word, even later. So it should be written, Bereshit bara Elokim shamayim va'aretz. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. Why et? To tell you that before the physical creation was Aleph Tav. Those are the 22 letters of the alphabet, which builds a man, the chromosome, 22 chromosomes. And everything definitely depends on the letters, Aleph, Tiv, Tav. So, let us finish here, wishing you Ktiva v'chatimah tova, a good writing, a good signature, right?